Welcome to this HTML and CSS crash course with Benjamin.
What will you be learning in this series? During this HTML and CSS crash course, you will discover necessary elements behind becoming a web developer. The objective of this crash course is to take someone who is a mouse and keyboard user and teach them the essentials of web development by teaching HTML, CSS, and some HTML5. This is a fundamental course for learning HTML, and it does not assume that participants have prior knowledge. By the end of the crash course, you will know the essentials for creating your first website application. The table of content for this course is the first thing which we'll be doing is we'll be setting up a website environment, that is an environment for us to write our codes and then check it out on our browser. And then we'll be talking about basic formatting using HTML tags, using hyperlinks, adding images, organizing our text by using tables. And we'll be talking about the introduction to cascading style sheets, which is CSS. We'll be talking about formatting text. We'll be talking about CSS box model, HTML5 and new tags, adding multimedia to our web pages. Now, let's quickly set up our environment to make our first website template. So what we'll be doing is the first thing is we're going to download an IDE from sublimetext.com. So if you're on your PC right now, open up your Google Chrome or any browser of your choice and visit www.sublimetext.com, just like you're seeing on the screen right now. When you visit this website, make sure to click on the download link on the website. I'm working on a Windows machine right now, and I just click on download, and it's going to download. Right click on your mouse and come to new folder, and then just name it tutorial. You can name it whatever you like, but I'm going to name my tutorial for the sake of this lesson. I already created my folder, and afterwards in that folder that you've created, that's where we're going to be working. That's where we're going to be doing all of the coding for our first HTML page. You can name your folder whatever you like. Mine is tutorial. Then open your Sublime Text, create a file and name it index.html. So after you've done that, we can actually get started. File here. If you want to save this file, Control S. If you're on a Mac machine, it's going to be Command and Hex. And then just go to your desktop. Go to your desktop where you created your folder, and choose the folder that you created. I've chosen mine, and then you can just name it index.html, and you can save the file type as HTML. So just choose HTML as your save as type, and then name this index.html. I already have my index.html file here. That's why you're seeing it as a Google Chrome icon. And this .html simply means the extension which you're using to save your file. So the browser or your computer or your machine knows that this file is an HTML document. That's why it's good to name your files with extensions. Now let's quickly go back to HTML is the language in which most websites are written. HTML is used to create pages and make them functional. The code used to make them visually appealing is known as CSS, that is cascade styling sheet. And we shall focus on this in a later tutorial. But first of all, let's focus on teaching you how to build rather than design. So CSS is for the designing part, HTML is for the building part. Let's quickly touch the history of HTML before we move further. Now, HTML was first created by Tim Berners and Robert Collier, and others started working on it in 1989. So you can see that it's a long time language. It stands for Hypertext Markup Language. That is HTML, Hypertext Markup Language. Now, hypertext means that the document contains links that allows the reader to jump to other places in the document or to another document altogether. The latest version of the HTML is HTML5. Now, a markup language is a way that computer speaks to each other to control how text is processed and presented. To do this, HTML uses two things, which are tags and attributes. Now, we're going to be talking about tags before we talk about attributes. So what are tags and attributes? Tags and attributes are the basics of HTML. They work together but perform different functions. Now, tags are used to mark up the start of an HTML element, and they are usually enclosed in angle brackets. An example of a tag is what you're seeing on my screen right now, which is this angle bracket. Then you have the doc type. This doc type HTML is telling the browser that this file is an HTML file. You will see that shortly when we start to write our codes. Now, most tags must be opened and closed in order for it to function. If you open a tag in HTML, it is right for you to close the tag. Now, what are HTML attributes? HTML attributes contain additional pieces of information. Attributes take the form of an opening tag and an additional information is placed inside. An example of an attribute will be seen when we use the image tag. The image tag has attributes, so it tells the browser what that image is all about. Now, the golden rules to remember is that the vast majority of tags must be opened and closed with the element information such as title or text resting between the tags. Now, if you look here in this document, which we have here, we have HTML, we have head, and in the head, we have the title tag, and the title tag encapsulates your title, which we have, this is your title, and then we close the title tag. Now, after closing the title tag, we close the head tag, and then the next one is the body tag. So the body tag is opening right here, and we are having H1 opening, H1 closing, the P tag opening, the P tag closing, and you see what's in the middle, what's embedded in. This is your header, this is your paragraph. And then the body tag, which we opened up here, is being closed beneath. And then remember that we opened the HTML tag, and we are closing that same HTML tag underneath it. So what to have in mind is that when using multiple tags, the tags must be closed in order in which they were opened. So these, we are using multiple tags here, and when it's opened, we close it immediately. So those are the golden rules to remember while you're working with HTML. Practice right now and we'll see how our first website looks. So let's get to work. Slide, let's quickly create our first HTML page. And what are we going to do? Angle bracket first, exclamation mark, and then we define our doc type. And then we say HTML. This is telling the browser that this is an HTML document. Now, the next thing which we'll do is what? We tell the browser that we're working with HTML, and then we'll close the tab. And we'll come down here and close it. Now I've opened an HTML tag here and I've closed it here, which is the right thing to do. Now let's open the head tag and let's close it again. The formatting, you don't need to worry yourself about the formatting, because with time you'll get used to the formatting. Now, after the head tag, let's just come here again and do what? Let's open the body tag. And I'm still going to close the body tag again, because whatever we open in HTML is good, we close it. Now, what do we want to do here? Let's just put in our title bar, our title tag rather. And then let's say this is our title. And then we do what? We just close it. And then in the body tag, let's just say that we want to include H1. And then we say this is our H1 tag. And then we do what? We just close it. Now, press your Ctrl S, save it, and then let's go back to our browser and check what we have in our browser. You see what we have? Look at this. This is our title. Look at where our title is coming up. This is our title. You see that? And then we have the body. This is the body tag here, which is showing up, which is displaying here. So here we have our first website, or our first web page. It's a very basic one, but as time goes on, we'll be working on this project and making it look much more better than this. So let's go back to our Sublime Text and try to do some more magic. Actually, there's nothing magical here. Everything we're just doing is we're following basic convention. We're following the basic convention of creating a web page. Now, this is your average HTML page, and this is how HTML is being structured visually. Now, we want to talk about more tags, but before we talk about more tags, let me quickly run you through something. If you look here now, you will see that every tag that we've opened, we close it. Every tag that is opened, we close it. And you will see that we arrange these tags to be very readable. Okay, now let me quickly chip in something. In programming, in web development, there is what we call comments. It's a very good thing that while you write your code, you can include comments so that your code can be very, very readable by others. Now, how do we add comments? We had comments in different forms. You could add comments with double slash. You can add comments with Control Shift and slash. And it's just going to give you the tag for the comment. But here in the course of this tutorial, I'm not going to talk much on comments because we might not be needing much of it here for now, for a start. When we get to more technical areas or more complicated areas in our coding journey, then we'll start to talk about comments and other parts of coding. Now, in our tags, we have other different tags. Apart from the title tag, we have meta tags. Meta tags are where information about the document is stored. Character encoding, the name, the page context, the description, and a whole lot of other information. So here, I want to quickly add some meta tags within this document. So where are we going to add our meta tag? We're going to add our meta tag on the header. Now I'm just going to create in this place here, after the HTML tag, I'm just going to add meta. I'm just going to add meta tag. You see, it's already adding some sort of information for us, which is the charset UTF-8. Now, I'm going to add another meta tag, and then this one, I'll just give it name. So it's going to be, I'm going to call it description. Description, and then I'm going to add content. Sorry, that's content. So it's content, so to be content. And I'm just going to say, this is our first website. Now, I want to add another meta tag. You know, meta is more about information for this page. So I'm going to add another meta, and I'll just put name again, and I'm going to say this is for author, and then I'm going to put my name as the author, and I'll say Olu Ben. So you can add as many metas as you like in on the other part of your HTML page. Okay, you can add as many meta tags as you like. So now all of these metas, I'm just going to cut them off here. And then I'm going to place them within the head tag. Okay, I'm going to place them within the head tag. And then I'm just going to bring this up. So it looks a little bit better now, right? Now, you would see that within the head tag, we already have a lot of things. This is the head opening tag, and then this is the closing tag for the head. And in between, we have all of these other tags. Now, when we start working with CSS, we're still going to add more tags here. Like, we can actually add the link tag, link. You see, it's giving us the link tag that we can actually style sheet. You know, we said we're going to be working with CSS. So we can actually add CSS to this website through the link tag. But we're not going to do that now. We're just going to leave, we just want to get more used to HTML first before we move further, so as not to confuse you. Now, let's start to add content to our website. If you save this now and then you go back to your browser, you will notice that there's no serious change here on this browser. You see, I'm refreshing it, but there's no serious change. The only way you can know if there's a serious change is if you just click, as you're on the page, just press Control and U. You see that everything that we added on our Sublime Text, you're seeing it here, but it's not visible here. This place is the source, this is the view source file. So you're seeing everything that you've added. You see, it's telling us this is an HTML document type, and you have your description here, you have your author and all of that. All of this meta, it's been used by the browser engine. Okay, everything in the head tag is going to be used by the browser engine, and it, most of it is not going to be visible to the users. Okay, but anything in the body tag, most of it will be visible to the users. So keep that in mind while we start to add contents to our first web page. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to drop it in the comment section. I'm going to be attending to every question one after the other.
Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the series, please subscribe. See you in the next one.